Republican bet Donald Trump clinches a required number of votes to be the 47th president of the United States. As of 7 p.m. Manila time, Trump has secured more than the 270 electoral votes needed to win the race, while Democratic nominee Kamala Harris sits at 224 electoral votes. Trump is only the second former president to win back the White House after losing re-election while in office. In a rousing speech before his supporters, Trump called his comeback the greatest political movement of all time.
There's never been anything like this in this country and maybe beyond. And now it's going to reach a new level of importance because we're going to help our country heal. We're going to help our country heal. We have a country that needs help, and it needs help very badly. We're going to fix our borders. We're going to fix everything about our country.
First part, Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he looks forward to working with Trump on a wide range of issues that will yield mutual benefits. Marcos adds he knows Trump's robust leadership will result in a better future for all. We begin with futures for Wall Street. They're surging to records as Donald Trump claims victory over Kamala Harris in the U.S. presidential election. Some analysts say a Trump win was likely priced in, and the incoming election results are providing certainty, which markets are craving. Popular Trump trades are on the move, with Bitcoin surging to new records. European shares, meanwhile, are tracking the rise in U.S. stock futures, with a benchmark pan-European stock 600 up around 1.7%, on pace for its biggest single-day advance this year. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Trump's media business and Tesla as investors cheer the former president's stunning election victory. Shares of Trump Media surged nearly 32% in pre-market trading. Shares of Tesla, which is owned by staunch Trump supporter Elon Musk, trading higher by 15%. Also in focus, shares of Novo Nordisk, which reported a third quarter beat on sales of its blockbuster weight loss drug Wegovy. Shares of Novo Nordisk jumped 8%. We're also keeping a close watch on BMW after it reported an 83% drop in net profit in the third quarter. Shares of the German carmaker slumped 4%. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mixed as investors assess another Trump presidency. Chinese shares led declines on trade worries as Trump had promised to impose tariffs of 60% or more on Chinese goods. Meanwhile, Japan's Nikkei 225 jumped 2.6%, boosted by a weak yen and the BOJ meeting minutes, which showed central bankers agreed to keep hiking rates if economic conditions are met. Here at home, the local bourse slumped 1.3%.
It's a knee-jerk reaction because you were expecting the other side to win, but that's okay. Business will go on. Although they will be focusing internally, right, make their country great, they might have increased tensions with China. But in a way, that doesn't mean that BPOs will get hit anyway because they really need us. So we are very strategic to them. I think they'll be, as the economy should grow, then there'll be more opportunities for us to do business there. So it's also positive from that perspective, especially our services and maybe some of our exports would have new markets in the U.S.
Here's some local corporate headlines. House lawmakers approve on third and final reading a bill renewing Meralco's franchise for another 25 years. 186 lawmakers voted in favor of the measure. 7 opposed the bill, 4 abstained. Meralco's current franchise is set to expire in 2028. In earnings news, San Miguel Food and Beverage saw its 9-month bottom line grow 11% to 30.4 billion pesos. Its chairman, Ramon Ang, cites the strength of its diversified portfolio, as well as strategic investments, cost management, and adapting to market trends. Taking a look at its units, EBITDA of its food segment jumped 39% thanks to top-line growth and lower raw material costs. Its beer and spirit segments also up thanks to higher prices and volumes. Meanwhile, Ayala Land's 9-month net income climbs to 21.2 billion pesos. It attributes this to stable property demand and consumer activity, which pushed revenues to over 125 billion pesos. And finally, Century Pacific's net income rose to 5.3 billion pesos as sales jumped to nearly 57 billion. The company behind Century Tuna and Vita Coco also saw its branded segment staying resilient despite what it described as a soft consumer environment.